With the new webhooks capability in Qlik Cloud services, you have more control over how your analytics supply chain communicates with enterprise applications. And that's because webhooks allow the Qlik platform to send automated messages pointing end users toward a call to action or directing services to orchestrate new tasks automatically. Blendr is Qlik's new application automation platform, enabling you to automate any manual application integration task, including Qlik Sense. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to create a webhook that sends Qlik Sense app reload statuses to Microsoft Teams using Blendr. Let's begin by adding a new blend. Every blend begins with a start block, and there are a variety of ways it can be configured. The webhook start type makes a dropdown appear where I can select Qlik Cloud services. I've added an API key from my tenant so the start block is ready to listen for events. Selecting the app reload finished event enables me to send a message to Teams when a reload of a specific app finishes. When you select an event, a test payload is provided so you can craft the blend with variables without having to run it first. It's a nice handy dandy feature. This next part is super cool because of the way QCS events are added to Blendr. When I save the blend, it automatically creates the webhook entry in the Qlik management console. So if I go into the entry, the URL for the webhook is present and the event I selected in the blend editor is checked. It's a really nice time saver because it eliminates the extra step of configuring the webhook manually in QCS. Next up, I'm going to set up some conditions and variables to control the automation. Blendr provides a base set of actions you can use to perform different processing tasks in an automation. In addition to these action blocks, Blendr includes connectivity to over 500 different SaaS applications you can bring together to automate your work. I want to run this automation only when my consumer sales Qlik Sense app finishes a reload. So my first block out is a condition block. The condition block is your standard if-then-else statement in an automation, and it's feature-rich. Blendr makes it easy to substitute message data by allowing you to pick attributes from previous blocks. In this case, I'm adding a condition to evaluate the app name to be equal to consumer sales. I'm going to add a second condition block inside the first to evaluate the event status. Variable blocks in Blendr help store reusable information during a blend run. When I drag the variable out to the editor and click inside the configuration, I'm prompted to create the variable because none exists. I'm creating a string variable here to store the result I want to send to Teams through a send message block that I'm going to set up shortly. Another cool feature of Blendr is mixing text with attributes from the webhook message. You can add attribute references by clicking on the name in the run history. Now I'll copy the block and paste in an open area of the editor and then drag it into the no path, changing a quick word like so, and now we've got success and failure messages. Next up, I'm going to add a formatted message for Microsoft Teams using adaptive cards and then send the message to a channel. The first Teams block I want to add takes a JSON object containing the adaptive card metadata. I generated an adaptive card JSON object earlier, so I'm just going to paste it into the card JSON input. Now, if I want to modify a couple of strings in the JSON to pick up variables from earlier in the blend, I need to toggle the formula parsing, which enables me to add the coded representations of the variables into this JSON string. Once the variables are added, I can turn formula parsing back on and the cool variable representations reappear. The last block to add is the send message block from Teams. In this block, I set the team I want to send the message to and specify a channel as well for it to land. In the content field, I need to specify the attachment ID representing the adaptive card that I created in the previous block, and then I can add the whole block to the attachment field. Time to save the configuration and try it out. Okay, testing out webhooks with Blendr and Microsoft Teams. I've got a split screen here with a ClickSense app using a Control00 script and Microsoft Teams. I'm going to press the reload button on the data load editor, and when the script run finishes, the formatted message appears in the Teams channel that I specified. And there you have it. Qlik's new webhooks capability combined with its new automation tooling provides analytics ops automations and connects your analytics to limitless possibilities for active intelligence. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.